Hey YouTube, we're in the South Island of New Zealand in their beautiful Prius here, car camping for a week. We're going to be heading from Christchurch down to Queenstown, up along the west coast and back to Christchurch through Arthur's Pass. Got some sweet drone shots here. This is the Waimak Bridge, big long one lane bridge near Arthur's Pass. We will later see the longest one-lane bridge in New Zealand down on the west coast. I got a little something that I want to lay out. It took a little while before I figured it out. Cause I've grown tired of trying to win. And I've been working on my garden this winter. Grew 6 broccolis. They're getting pretty massive. Here they are. So I figured I'd better pick one to take on the trip with me. This one actually ended up lasting me 3 nights. Either it's a big broccoli or I don't eat too much. Getting some fuel. Through the last of the traffic and then we'll be on the open road. Oh yeah, baby. Kaya Gorge now. They got some nice bridges and today a couple of people hooning around on their jet boats.
Cool bridges.
At the Arundel Bridge, the new one. I love when there's a bit of history of old bridges around. There's couple of pilings here. I believe that one's from 1930 bridge, and further up the valley the sign was saying parts of Lord of the Ring were filmed up there. Nice.
I hope nobody actually thinks I'm driving this fast. That would be impossible. Pretty cool windy roads though. It's pretty fun. Keeps you awake anyway.
We've just stopped in Fairley for a pie. They're famous for their pies here. Not these ones though. Still pretty good though. It's getting a bit chilly now, good view, but I've got to find a place to park up for the night soon here. So I've been following this gravel road for a while. And I think this is as far as I can go because I would have to drive through a river. And I don't think Priuses are made for that.
So I keep my bed in the back, my pillow. Yeah, the mattress. Under here is snow chains, spare gas, all my cooking things.
Good morning, just waking up here on the lake. The stars were really good last night and I could just lie in here with my pillow and look straight up at the stars. I saw about 8 shooting stars while lying in bed. It's real nice.
The spot for the first night, down by the lake. Found this dodgy little road in the dark. It's kind of worried I wouldn't be able to make it down, but it's turned out to be really nice. We're now near Lake Benmore. There's another dam, long way down. So many dams around here. Cool. In here they've got a
one of the turbine blades for size.
Bigger than the car.
Line, quite a famous bungee jumping place near Queenstown. I think it was one of the first places to ever do bungee jumping in the world. The first place to commercialise it and sit inside or come out and watch people jumping off the red bridge on a freezing cold day, getting their head dunked in the water. I do love a campground with a river and a beach. You can make little dams if you get bored. Go swimming if it was way warmer than it is now. And here's the lake. Pretty nice. Wish there were a bit less clouds though, but it's pretty good. So here's my spot for the second night. Not the nicest spot in the park, but it's in a little depression area, so I figured it would kind of keep the engine noise away from other campers. This is the shot over river where the jet boats go. I guess this is an old bridge which they've left for walking and biking, which is awesome. Love old bridges. There's the Remarkables road bridge and some people on their bikes. The Crown Range towards Cadrona ski field. This road is ridiculously steep, switchbacks most of the way up. Pretty fun, but your brakes get quite hot if you're coming down. I'd much rather go up it. Here's the actual speed. My poor Prius trying to go up here. See the clouds down below us. And it still goes up, 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 way above the clouds. And now I've actually been up to Cadrona at this point. I'm coming back down from the ski field through the clouds. I only spent about 10 minutes up there because it was the evening and they were going to be closing soon. Plus, check out this horrific fog. Who wants to drive through this in the dark? So I thought I'd better get down quick. We're in Wanaka now. Nice and peaceful. Quite chilly though. And the food is expensive, so I'm going to keep going and find a place to camp tonight. These one-lane bridges crack me up. This one's so busy, they added traffic lights instead of putting a two-lane bridge in. So, good morning. For the third night, I slept on the shore of this lake next to Lake Wanaka. Not sure what the name is. You have to drive down some dodgy road for about 15-20 minutes. Pretty muddy, I wasn't sure if I was going to make it out, so we'll find out, I'm sure I will. And there's a bunch of other people who decided to come up. Even this guy in his car. So, I'm not the only one sleeping in the car there. So here's the bed, fully made up. It's actually pretty cozy, there's not much headroom, but I can fully stretch out and I'm 6'2". Not bad, $8 a night. They had a tap, so I washed some of my dirty dishes. Flushing toilet even. Yeah. The last place was $15 and had a long drop and nowhere to wash everything. So, big improvement. Yeah, we got some cows on the road. Like, heaps of them. They're pretty cute though, they're pretty woolly. Oh, don't go in front of me. Where are you going? Where are you going? Oh no, that one's humping. Oh, that one's pooping. That one's humping again. Oh my god, it goes on. Okay, I think I see the end. But there's so many cows at the end.
Okay, so I gotta spin the wheels a bit and it scares them. Oh, that guy is big! Thank you! Oh my god! That took forever! So I just had to drive through all these cows. They did not want to move. That was kind of fun though. I'm glad I made it. It was really muddy and I was a little bit worried that I'd get stuck because I'd keep stopping. What a shame you're not allowed campfires, because look at all the stuff that would burn so well. You've got big tree stumps all over. It'd be perfect. I saw a sign pointing to this trail called Blue Pools or something, so I thought I'd check it out. It's a really nice trail. So far, I'd say you'd be able to ride a lime scooter down it. Not that there's any around here. Would be creepy as shit walking through here at night time. But I'm not going to go all the way because it said hour and a half each way, and that is too far for me today. But yeah, pretty nice. Look at that nice green pool. Just on half past now. Couple of snowflakes coming down. And every now and then when the clouds lift a little bit, you can see snow on the trees hiding though. Love how clear it is. I'm sure it's quite deep there. Must have been a bad waterfall. It's all locked away. Sun's starting to come out. Pretty nice. Pretty nice spot. That is a little bit scary though. Big ass crack. Oh yeah. Look at this sign. You would hardly even know it's there. Bit of information about the mountain. Oh yeah, there's another good one. A rainbow right there. Beautiful. Jeez, no wonder these trees fall over. Look at it. Nothing to it. Donut things. I bet those are so heavy. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Solar powered wind turbine and generator for a satellite emergency phone in the middle of nowhere. Nice. Tiny bridges. Nice spot. Check out those mountains down the end. Oh, check it out. We got two Priuses. Oh, yeah. Oh, this is pretty cool. Little cable way across the river. Looks like you plug a generator into it and it will pull you across. Nice. So this one's weird. No sign, another little box, and you get full cell phone reception. 3G internet, can watch YouTube videos, make calls. Just in this tiny little car park area here though, the range doesn't go very far.
Very nice spot, but it's pretty weird how there's no sign saying, hey, there's cell phone reception here. There's about 2 hour drive back that way to get to the nearest reception spot.
This is the Haast River Bridge. It's New Zealand's longest one-way bridge at 737 meters. Pretty impressive.
This is interesting. They've rerouted the road, and you can see why. This is looking very dodgy up here. Probably not staying here too long. I found this spot that I could stay at for free, but I don't know. I want to have a couple of drinks and I don't want to be hassled, so I might just go to the campground down the road. There we go, I think I'll camp here tonight. Got here a little earlier than the other nights.
Still a little light so I can actually
see where I want to camp, which is good. $15, but it's worth it for the view, I reckon. So this is generally how I'll spend my night. Get my chair, put my sleeping bag in it so that it's the cold breeze isn't coming up my ass.
Surround myself with food and then just cook dinner. Got some cider there and I'm gonna watch the sunset.
Just making up one of my meals here. Got the water, the milk powder, and using up the last of my broccoli.
That piece I grew at home has lasted me 3 days. It was a pretty huge head there.
And just gonna enjoy the rest of my night watching the view.
Good morning, just had the made breakfast down there by the river. This is the entrance to Fox Glacier.
Coffee time! Oh yeah!
Guess I had a little too much caffeine.
Here's my camper van, parked up with all the other camper vans. And hook a ticket now.
Back to
somewhat of civilization and cell phone service. This is my favorite spot in Greymouth. Checking out the surface. This will be my last night. I'm at Lake Brunner right now. Still haven't figured out where to sleep tonight, but this is a pretty nice spot. Just woke up, so I'll be back in town today, but I slept up on Arthur's Pass, right near the top. It's pretty cold, it was -3, but it stayed pretty nice and warm in the car with the
heater running all night.
There we go, let's see.
Pretty thick.
Ooh. Okay, it's decent. I can see little bugs swimming around under the ice.
Punch Bowl Falls in Arthur's Pass. Very nice. So I've gone beyond the barrier to get closer. And it's pretty epic. There's like two valleys. Here's the bottom. Some good ice wind coming off there. Woo, yeah. And it is so icy. All the ground is just like concreted in with ice. They're helicoptering trees, what the heck?
Stopped at this campsite for a little poop ski. Interesting. They got water. A three
walled hut with a fireplace, but no front wall. Huh.
Making a coffee and some lunch here before I head over the hill back into Christchurch. Check out all that mud on there. Ooh-wee. It's been on an adventure. Now that is impressively slow. I don't get it. We have a train, yet they must be cheaper to drive everything over the hill at half a mile an hour.
And we're back in Christchurch. Hope you enjoyed the video, everyone. Give it a thumbs up if you did. And if you didn't, you probably wouldn't still be watching. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. Thank you. I encourage you to go and take your own road trip, even if you don't have much money right now. This one only cost me about $2.50 in fuel for 6 days. That includes leaving the car running during the night. And everything else was pretty cheap. Just food and maybe $10 or $15 for campgrounds.